Welcome to Community Box. In this video, we're going to show you how to add a directory onto your Squarespace website. So for this example, we have a shop website and we're going to create a stockists page, which will have a directory added onto it. So we'll start on the Community Box dashboard in that directory management area. And under the look and feel tab, you'll see there's an option that says preview and embed your directory. So if you click on preview and embed page link, you can then choose where the directory is going to be added to. So in this case, it's a Squarespace site. And then we've got some specific bits of code we need to copy and paste. Don't worry, you don't need to understand any of this code. You're literally just copying and pasting it. So the first step is to add a piece of code to the site header. So you will need to be on the Squarespace business plan or above in order to add this code. So I'm going to press copy and then go over to my Squarespace site. Then I'm going to go into pages and scroll right down to the bottom to website tools. And then where it says code injection, that's where we're going to add this code, and you can just paste it into the header section and then press save. So that's basically saying we're loading Community Box on the website, but you still need to tell it which page you want the directory to be on. So that's why we need this second piece of code here, which we're going to add to a code block on a page. So let's copy this code. And on the Stockist page, you'll see that I've got it twice. That's because there are two different editor versions on Squarespace. So I'm going to show you how you can add it for both. So the most modern Squarespace sites, the ones that have been created recently, will use this layout option, which is where you have the option to add a block in the top left corner, and you can move things around on the screen freely. Normally when you drag any content blocks, you see a grid appear in the background. So that's what you will have if you've just created a Squarespace site fairly recently. So if you're on this editing version, we'll go to add block and then scroll down to the code option here, and that's going to add a code block. Now if you've already got text, it might add it over the top of your text. So you can move the code block down to where you want the directory, and you'll see that it's actually putting the code block in just a small box here. So I would recommend stretching it out to however wide you want the directory to be. Then we can edit this code block. You can also double click on it to go into edit mode. We're going to delete this hello world message and then make sure we've got this code copied, and then we're going to paste that in. So once you've done that, let's just save. And then you'll see a message asking you to register your domain if you haven't added Community Box before. So you'll need to do this both for the Squarespace built-in domain and your public-facing domain. So for example, if this was called thriveretail.com, then we'd have to register that domain as well. There's a link here that you can click on, and that will take you to the domain registration area. And you can add your domain. It will automatically show you the domains that it detects Community Box is registered on as well. So this is the right one. So we'll press add, and that's registering our domain. And you'll see that's now showing as registered. So now if we refresh the page, you'll see the directory is loading. So just wanted to highlight a couple of things that can trip people up on this version of the Squarespace editor. So if I go into edit mode again, sometimes you'll forget to resize the code block. And so if Community Box is looking weird and squished up like this, then it probably means you need to move the code block and extend it out to the full width. Then it will look correct, like we had it before, like that. If you're finding that some or all of the profiles are not clickable, it might be that you've got the code block that's actually accidentally behind one of the other text boxes or another type of content block on the site. So here you can see it's quite obvious because we have the text here, and we can't click on this profile picture because there's text on top of it, but we can click on this profile picture because the text block isn't on top of it. So if you're having issues with not being able to click something, when you're in edit mode, double check if there's any, maybe an empty text block or anything like that, that might be on top of the code block. And you want to make sure that the code block is showing as being at the front. So if you want to move it forward, if there is an overlap that you need to have for some reason, just make sure that the code block is right at the front there. The other thing you need to be aware of is that on this version of editing in Squarespace, you set the desktop and the mobile designs separately. So if we click into the mobile view here, then you might find that, again, the code block isn't quite in the right place. Perhaps the text block is a bit too long, or if the code block might be behind the text block, again, you'll have the same issue where the profiles won't be clickable or everything will be overlapping. So what you want to make sure is that any blocks are not overlapping. Even a tiny bit of overlap like that can cause some problems. So you want to make sure that you've got the block before it finishing, and then the code block starts with a nice clean gap in between. And then if you want to, you can just pull up this section here as well, so there's not too much extra space. So let's go back to the desktop view. We've also got this classic editor, and if you're on version 7.1 of Squarespace, which is the newest version of Squarespace, then it will look like this. You'll have probably a little upgrade button there. You don't have the add block option. Instead, when you hover over one of these little plus insert points, you'll then get the option to add your blocks in this way. So if you were adding community box to a classic editor section, click on this little plus, and go to code, and then repeat the exact same process. So you're gonna paste in the community box directory. I'm gonna remove it from up here because we can't have two directories on the same page. And then you'll see it's now loading down here. On this version, the mobile display is done automatically, so you don't need to worry about that. You don't have to worry about overlapping code blocks or anything like that, but you can do it on either version. If your Squarespace looks a bit different to all of this, you might be on version 7.0, which is an older version of Squarespace. So if you're on version 7.0, you'll have the same editing experience as the classic editor, in that you'll click on the plus symbol here and you'll choose a code block and you will add that to your page. One final thing I wanted to mention about Squarespace is that sometimes the editor can interfere with how Community Box loads and is laid out. So if you want to test the site, it's always worth doing that on a private browsing window. It's called incognito mode in Chrome, or private browsing in most other browsers. And the way you can do that if your site isn't live is if you go to settings, and then click on site availability. You can then set a password for your site and then save that. And then if you just type in just this bit here without the config, so whatever your built-in domain is, it might be bananaparrot2632.squarespace.com, type that in and then type the password in a private browsing window. That will give you the most accurate experience of how Community Box is going to look on your live site. So that's how to add Community Box to a Squarespace site. If you have any other questions, please reach out to us via our website at communitybox.co.